The president has dubbed it the American Families Plan. As ABC 7's Samantha Serban shows, one big chunk of it involves spending $225 billion to help parents pay for childcare, plus universal preschool.
3-year-old Abigail loves to play with her friends on the playground. But is she excited for school?
Oh, I am, I am.
I can sit here and teach her until I'm blue in the face, but at the end of the day, I'm just mom.
Samantha Taff is like many moms in Charlotte County. It's easier for her to stay home with the kids than go to work.
I know when I just had one in preschool, I was about $1,200 a month.
But a new plan from President Biden may allow Taff to send Abigail to preschool for free, and her baby too, in a few years.
Oh, it would mean the world. It would change totally everything. It would open up all these new doors that I thought weren't even possible for another couple years.
Felicia DiCiano says her daughter is already past the pre-K age, but as a single mom, she understands the need for free programs.
I think it's important for the parents to have a sense of that their children are going to be taken care of and that they're going to be learning and that they're able to work to, you know, make money to pay bills.
Preschool teaches not only reading and math skills, but socialization.
I think it's great for them. They love it more than anything.
By sending her to preschool, she learned how to play with other children and be a part of a group, which I think is important.
Research shows universal preschool gives kids a better chance at success, more likely to take honors classes, less likely to repeat a grade. The president's plan also aims to allow moms like Taff to rejoin the workforce, which she says would help tremendously.
Just to be able to get them in school and not have to worry so much about money, and then I wouldn't feel so guilty for staying home with the kids, even though that's a job too, but it's just not bringing in any money.
Samantha Serban, ABC.